All right, my man. It's day, what day is this? It's day 15, I believe.
Day 12?
It was, we started Friday, 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
14?
Yesterday would have been 14, so 15. Maybe, I don't know. What day is it, 26? Yeah, today's 26. August 26th, we're gonna be doing the whole pre-trip again, and then we'll start off with the lights.
We love the lights.
It ain't me loving the lights. It's, I gotta make sure I get you on the lights. You gotta get it right.
I'm gonna get it right today. Alrighty. I'm gonna check my lights.
You see what I mean, people? There's like a 10-second delay right there, and it's like, I'm gonna get my lights.
Remember, your day's coming.
What are you trying to say?
You'll remember this conversation.
Okay, it's coming. Oh, come on, man.
I'm now going to check my lights. For lights, reflectors, and reflector tape to see that they're probably minus secure, not cracked, been broken. They are working properly. They're working properly, and the colors are proper and of proper color. Amber to the front and sides, reds to the back. Parking light, clearance lights, marker light. Tape. I almost missed it again. My reflectors and marker lights. Reflector tape. My marker light. ABS and marker light. Clearance lights. DOT tape. DOT tape, marker light, DOT tape on the ICC. Lovely. Marker light. Marker light. Marker light. Marker light. Marker light. Headlight. Now we'll perform my 5x5, which is 5 functions, 5 locations. Those functions are, or the locations are, I'm sorry. My front headlight, front headlight, the rear headlight. Tractor of the trailer and the rear tail light. I think I missed that. Okay, the functions, the 5 functions are my 4 ways. My 4 ways, my high beams.
Hold on.
My 4 ways, my high beams, my left and right turn signal, truck and trailer. Right turn signal, truck and trailer, and my brake lights. Instructor, will you now assist me in checking those lights?
Yes, I will. So that, are you done with the lights?
Yes, I am.
All right. First of all, you have to remember that what you have is reflective tape, not DOT tape.
I know, I have a... Yeah.
You know, you keep saying DOT.
Yeah, because that's...
You know, it's reflective tape.
Yeah.
Not only that, When you talk about the mud flap, make sure that you say the reflective tape on the mud flap and reflective tape on the trailer.
Okay.
When you come back up here, you did everything good. When you come back up here, you're gonna say, I'm gonna do my five functions in five different locations. You said my first function was, no, your location, you said it was on the front headlight, which I don't know if that is a location.
Yeah,
that's a function. That's a headlight. It's not even a function. It's not a location or a function.
Right.
It's just a headlight, you know what I mean? So you gotta make sure you study that. We getting better.
Yeah, getting closer.
But you wanna get better. You know what I mean? Let's go ahead and do the trailer.
My header board, it is probably mounted secure. That crack been a bolt broken. No holes or missing rivets. My frame rail is properly mounted secure. That crack been broken. My cross members, they're probably mounted secure, not correct, but broken. None are missing. My landing gear is probably mounted secure, it's not correct, but broken. It's in the upright position, and the cradle is in the, is locked in the handle. That doesn't sound good.
Okay.
My landing gear is puppy mine is secure, it's not cracked, metal broken, and the handle is secure in the cradle. The tender release and release pin are puppy mine secure, they're not cracked, metal broken, and the tandem pin and the locking pin are in the lock position. This trailer here. Okay, I'm gonna go spring. Let's see any shocks on this trailer. Shocks again.
You're still gonna talk about it even though it doesn't have any?
It doesn't have, okay.
You're still gonna talk about the things that are supposed to be on it, because we're not gonna have a newer trailer, we're gonna have an older trailer that has all the stuff that's not on this one.
Okay. My spring arms are both ends are probably mounted secure.
Which one's your spring arms?
Or my spring mounts, I'm sorry. My spring mounts are probably mounted secure. They're not cracked, bent, or broken. My spring mounts are probably mounted secure, not cracked, bent, or broken on both ends. My spring mounts are probably mounted secure on both ends. They're not cracked, bent, or broken. None are missing. I'll just call it out. My shock absorber, it is probably mounted secure. On both ends, it's not cracked, bent, or broken. It's not leaking. My airbag is properly mounted secure. It's not cracked, bent, or broken. No abrasions, bulges, or cuts, and not missing any mounting bolts. Let's come back here. My brake chambers and hose, they're properly mounted secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, not leaking. The brake chamber hose, it is properly mounted secure on both ends, not cracked, bent, or broken, no abrasions, bulges, or cuts, not leaking. My slack adjuster and push rod, it is properly mounted secure, it's not cracked, bent, or broken. With the brakes released and pulled by hand, should be less than 1 inch. My brake drum is properly mounted secure, it's not cracked, bent, or broken. My brake linings, they're properly mounted secure, not cracked, bent, or broken. No oil residue, friction material is not worn dangerously thin. My trailer tire, it is properly mounted secure. Trailer tire is properly mounted secure, it's not cracked, bent, or broken. Trailer tire is probably mounted secure, not cracked, bent, or broken. No abrasion, bulges, or cuts to the tread or to the sidewall. The tread depth should be no less than 2/32. It's filled in manufacturer specs, and I would check that by using an air gauge. The rim, it is probably mounted secure, it's not cracked, bent, or broken. And no illegal welds. The lug nuts are all probably mounted secure, not cracked, bent, or broken. None are missing. No rust trails or powder residue, and no crack around the bolt holes. The axle seal was probably minor secure. It's not cracked, bent, or broken. No nuts are missing, and filled to manufacturer specs.
Missing anything?
My mud flap, I'm gonna just call it out. My mud flap is probably mine secure, it's not cracked, been broken, and it is not missing. My door, it is probably mine secure. It's not cracked, been broken. It opens and latches properly. Door hinges. All the door hinges are probably mine secure, not cracked, been broken, none are missing. Last but not least, my door sales are probably where it's secured, not cracked or broken. Your axe are not worn, torn, or dry rotted. That completes my trailer.
All right, I think the whole bags are on there. I'm not sure. We'll have to look at it. When you come over here, frame and tandem release. The frame and tandem release, that's what it's called.
Okay.
These are the spring mounts, front and back.
Okay.
That is your spring arm, front and back. You have the torque arm in here. And then, you come back over here, you talk about your airbag, your shock absorber, your brake chamber and hose, and the slack adjuster.
Get it all in one shot.
Yeah, you don't wanna go, you know, you bounce around too much, you tend to forget things.
Yeah.
And then, slack adjuster and push rod. With the brakes released and pulled by hand, it should not move more than 1 inch. That's important. They'll knock you down for that, all right? Trailer tire. I just want to make sure you do it. I can't remember you said something like that on that, but just want to make sure you do it, man. You do it right, you know what I mean? Because we want to get this.
Gotcha.
We about to head back out. You know, we got to get it. Then we gotta talk about this, cause you're the first one that said cradle. I don't know what that is. Yeah, you'll come up with some things, all right. You're good at coming up with things. Like I'll ask you by the sign, you'll be like, yeah, that's what that says. Nah. let's do the engine. You haven't done it in a while? Still only yesterday since we did it.
We didn't do it yesterday, dude. No, we didn't do it yesterday. Maybe AM in the morning, but I don't know. We've been rolling, baby. Looks like I'm gonna roll for this for you get people out of bills.
Yeah, because remember you owe me lunch. I'm gonna get fat, man.
Yeah, I'm
gonna be a big boy when I go home.
Alrighty, here we go, folks. All my general hoses on both ends are probably mine secure. They're not cracked or broken. No abrasions, bulges, or cuts. They're not leaking. This is a bell-driven alternator. The bell-driven alternator is probably mine secure. It's not cracked or broken. All connected wires. All the wires are connected. The belt is not cracked or fray. The free play should be no more than 1/2 and 3/4. I'm not gonna miss that part today. Cost me some money. All my general hoses. I should not have missed that. All my general hoses are probably mine secure, and both ends are not cracked or broken. No abrasions, bulges, or cuts, and they are not leaking. The air compressor is probably mine secure. It's not cracked or broken. The gear-driven air compressor is probably mine secure. Not cracked or broken. Not leaking. Car student pump. It is probably mine secure, not cracked, been broken. It is not leaking. The dipstick is probably mine secure, not cracked, been broken. Filled to manufacturer specs. I would check it by pulling it out. My bell-driven water pump is probably mine secure, not cracked, been broken. No abrasions, bulges, or cuts. Not leaking. The belt is not cracked or frayed. The free plate should be between 1/2 and 3/4.
Oh, you're going up here?
I'm going up here to cost me lunch. It cost me some money. My coolant reservoir is probably more insecure. It's not cracked, or broken. And filled to manufacturer specs. The power steering reservoir is probably more insecure. Not cracked, or broken. And it is filled to manufacturer specs. And it is not leaking. Power steering gearbox is probably minus a gear.
Wait. What is that?
This is the
he said he was gonna fly through this
people. I'm flying too fast. My steering gearbox. I'm just checking you. Steering gearbox and hose. It is probably minus secure, not cracked, been broken, not leaking. The steering gearbox hose. It is probably not secure, not cracked, or broken on both ends, no abrasions, bulges, or cuts. It is not leaking. My steering linkage, it is probably not secure, not cracked, or broken. No, not missing any carter pins or castle nuts and carter pins. Spring hangers on both ends are probably not secure, not cracked, or broken. None are missing. The leaf springs, they are probably minus secure, not cracked, or broken. None have shifted. My U-boats, U-joints are probably minus secure. Probably minus secure, not cracked, or broken. None are missing.
Are they U-joints?
U-boats.
So what are they? They're the U-joints, right?
They're a U.
There are you. No, there are you.
You. You boats.
Which one is it, Rodney? Come on, man.
My U-joints, man. My U-joints are probably mine secure. They're not cracked, brand broken, and none are missing.
Hold up. He said U-joints. After we messed around, got him confused, he said U-joints.
No, it's U-boats.
Oh, you want to change your mind now?
Yeah, let's go. We might want to get this fly here. Because this is serious, I gotta get this, man. I need the CDL. My U-joints, U-boats are probably aren't secure. Not cracked, been broken, none are missing.
All right, now just a clarification.
Okay.
What are they?
Instructor. Do you know the proper wording for this?
Bro, what are they, Randy? Hold up, for real, like what are
they're
they?
They're U-boats.
You sure?
U-joints, man. They're U-joints.
No, hold on. Come on. No.
They're U-joints. I'm going with U-joints, man.
Wait. It's a guessing game now?
No, it's not a guessing game. It's serious, man.
I'm
going with U-joints.
But why are you going with U-joints? Why aren't you going with what you know?
Yeah, because that's not a joint. This is bolts. These are bolts. Bolting down. Something's got to be fixed. It's U-boats.
I'm gonna ask you again, what are they?
I'm going with U-boats. So I'm probably gonna be wrong.
You're right. They're bolting something down, so yeah, they're a bolt.
Yeah.
They're not a joint.
U-boats.
Something leaking?
Yeah, it's this one here.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah, I saw that. My shock absorber on both ends are probably mine secure, not cracked, or broken, and they are not leaking. Looks like it's just a small.
Yeah.
It's something small, don't look major. But nothing's dripping down on the ground either. My brake chamber hose, it is probably minus secure. It's not cracked, or broken. And it is not leaking. The brake chamber hose, it is probably minus secure. Not cracked, or broken. No abrasions, bulges, or cuts. And not leaking. Slack adjuster and push rod is probably minus secure. Not cracked, or broken. With the brakes released and pulled back by hand, should be no more than 1 inch. The brake drum is probably minus secure. It's not cracked, or broken. The brake lining, it is probably minus secure. Not cracked, or broken. No oil residue. And the brake lining is not worn dangerously thin. This is the steer tire. The steer tire is probably minus secure. It is not cracked, or broken. No abrasions, bulges, or cuts to the thread, to the tread, or to the sidewall. The tread should be no less than 4/32 on the front. It's filled to manufacturer specs, and I would check this by using an air gauge. My rim is probably minus secure. It's not cracked, or broken. no illegal wells. The lug nuts, they are all properly mounted secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, not a missing, with no rust trails or powder residue, and no crack to the bolt holes. The hub seal is properly mounted secure, it's not cracked, bent, or broken, and it's filled to manufacturing specs. And that completes the engine.
All right, now remember, you want to be sure about what you're talking about, all right, man?
Yeah.
We don't want to come in here guessing what we're talking about, this and that, that and that, you know what I mean?
Okay.
You have to know what you're talking about, because when you get out there for real, you just got to know, man.
Yeah,
you got to know, all right? Let's do the coupling.
Coupling, my airlines are probably mine and secure. They're not cracked or broken, no abrasions, bones, and cuts, and not leaking. The electrical line unit is probably mine and secure, not cracked or broken, no abrasions, bones, and cuts, and no loose wires. And they're not touching the catwalk. Not touching the catwalk. The glide hands are probably mine and secure, not cracked or broken. The glide hand seals, they are probably mine and secure. Mine secure, no abrasions, bones, and cuts, not cracked, torn, or dry rotted, but not leaking. Trailer apron is properly mounted secure, it's not cracked, bent, or broken. Skid plate, it is properly mounted secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, and it's properly lubed. There's no gaps. There's no gap between the apron and the trailer platform.
So how many gaps can you have in between there?
Zero gaps, no gaps. My king pan, it is probably mine and secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, not missing. The locking jaw, it is probably mine and secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, and it is securely locked around the king pan. My platform, the platform is probably mine and secure, it's not cracked, bent, or broken. My mounting bolts, they are all probably mine and secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, none are missing. My release arm, the safety latch, it is probably mine and secure, and in the lock position. My fifth wheel and locking pin, they are all probably mine and secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, and the pin is in the lock position. My mud flap is probably mine and secure, not cracked, bent, or broken, and not missing. And that completes the coupling section.
You forgot the clearance?
That's right. It wasn't the mud flap. Clearance. I do have the proper clearance between my mud flap and my landing gear. So when I turn, they will not hit. So that is not
all right.
Included in the coupling.
So we're not going to do the driver's side, but how do you feel?
Giving your percentage, I'm going to say I'm 90%.
90% the...
As far as the outside. I just got a couple things I got to just clear up to put up that 10%. Excuse me. And I'm ready to roll. Inside. Get it done. And then fine-tune everything. Definitely daily. Two, three times a day. And let's go take the test, man. I want to get it done.
Well, we're going to take the test now.